Welcome to Life-Giving Water Messages, where I expound upon the Word of God and, through the internet, deliver it to you. My name is Reverend Todd Laddick, and today I'm bringing to you part two of a three-part series entitled Releasing God's Blessings, with today's message specifically entitled Blessed People Bless Others, based off of 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 6 through 10. So let us dive into the Word today. Remember this. A farmer who plants only a few seeds will get a small crop, but the one who plants generously will get a generous crop. You must each decide in your heart how much to give, and don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure, for God loves a person who gives cheerfully, and God will generously provide all you need. Then you will always have everything you need and plenty left over to share with others. As the scriptures say, they share freely and give generously to the poor. Their good deeds will be remembered forever. For God is the one who provides seed for the farmer and then bread to eat. In the same way, he will provide and increase your resources and then produce a great harvest of generosity in you. Amen. All that we are and all that we have come from God. I'll say that again. All that we are and all that we have come from God. We are stewards through whom God is blessing the world. We have all had times when finances were tight and resources were running low. I'm sure we all had to find ways to navigate through those tough times. My family and I have had our share of those times, that's for sure. Even recently, though I wouldn't say our situation is rough now, like some of the times we had earlier as younger adults with two children, but even recently, we've had times where we had to carefully decide what things we could keep spending on, what things we could no longer afford, mostly due to the fact for several years, Bernadette had a job that only paid during the school year. So in the summer, for example, after her vacation time ran up, her vacation pay, we would be living off of mostly my salary plus half of hers, because she would pick up, and the reason why she got half of her pay is because she would pick up as many hours as possible at her job to prepare for the next school year, review policies, whatever they had her doing. So she would get some pay from her job that way. And she's an hourly employee, so, you know, however many hours you put in, you get paid for it. But there are two worst times that I can think of to have a pay decrease like that. And that would be Christmas and the summer, aka vacation time for most. So in those moments, you know, I'd find myself canceling subscriptions such as Apple News, and Bernadette would cancel things that she liked and things that, you know, are important to us, but because we were trying to cut down and conserve. I mean, that's common when you're in those times. Our perception of supply impacts the way we use our resources, doesn't it? I mean, that's just kind of how it works. And think about times that you've experienced economic hardships, overscheduled weeks, or even the great toilet paper, hand sanitizer, and disinfectant wipe shortage of 2020. How did that impact your willingness to share these resources? How would you have shared these items differently if you knew that there was an unlimited supply? So I'll ask that again. How did those moments impact your willingness to share the resources you had a limited amount of? And how would you have shared those items differently if you knew that there was an unlimited supply, that it would just keep coming and coming and coming forever? Hashtag blessed. What does it mean? What does it mean to be blessed? The language of blessing can be tricky because it can lure us into the belief that people with material wealth are more favored by God than those without an abundance of financial resources. So while some in the summers are taking trips around the world and, having vacations in Tahiti and Hawaii, because I can't afford that per se, maybe I might feel a little less blessed than that person. But that's tricky, because is that true? And even more disturbing, we could be led to believe that material wealth is solely for our enjoyment. This is not what Christ modeled for us, nor is it how Christ spoke of blessings. The scripture today invites us into relationship with God, each other, and with our community by putting our trust in God. We need not wait for the perfect year or the perfect dividend check. It moves us from fear of scarcity to believing that God will provide for our daily bread. Friends, we often, and I've said this before, and it's so true, and it's more important for us to realize now with the situation our churches find themselves in following the pandemic, but I'll say this now, we often operate from an economy of scarcity rather than an economy of abundance. We believe that we have very little and that we're going to fold rather than having faith that God is all we need and we will thrive. And which do we have? Do we have a God of scarcity or a God of abundance? Which do we believe in? A reluctance to share with a generous heart suggests a refusal, actually, to trust that God is all-sufficient and gracious. Last week, we talked about knowing who we are, living into our legacy. This week's focus is on knowing whose we are. Those who belong to God and therefore can freely give from that relationship because we don't rely on ourselves. We are not self-made. I'll say that again. We are not self-made. So when you hear we are, quote unquote, blessed to be a blessing, we acknowledge that we are blessed so that we may bless others. That's the whole point of it. And to share God's love and hope. You may have heard the saying, hurt people, right? Like hurt people, people who are hurt, hurt people. Blessed people bless people too. So yes, hurt people do hurt people, but blessed people bless people. Out of God's blessing, we are called to be a blessing to others. The more you give, the more you receive. This is not about a transaction or a formula to get rich. It is about an overflowing and multiplying of blessings through faith in what God will do. When we give from a position of trust in God's provision, our heart will increase in ways that can be surprising and fulfilling beyond the financial. Generosity itself enriches. All that we have and all that we are is a gift from God. Today's scripture calls us to share. No matter what we sow, God is going to bless it and multiply it beyond our wildest imagination. Think of the blessings that you have received from God in your life. I want you to think about the blessings you've received from God in your life. These might be gifts of love, time, abilities, relationships, resilience, space, or material items such as belongings or financial resources. How are you sowing these seeds of grace? Are you sowing as if you will run out? Or are you sowing as if God will continue to provide for every good work? Do you hold back because you don't believe that God could use your gift? Or do you trust that God can take your mites and make them mighty? I want you all to imagine, to see even what I see. A God-sized vision, if you will. What if we were to sow abundantly, trusting that God will provide, will continue to provide the seeds of grace, as well as bless and multiply the faithful planting of those seeds by the community of faith? What would change in our community if people lived as if God would continually provide individuals with the resources they need and multiply the resources that were faithfully shared with others? Who is God trying to bless through the blessings you have been given? Let us be a people who are not limited in sight. Let us dream dreams and see visions. Let us be a people who sow seeds and reap more souls for the kingdom of heaven. Together, through our releasing of God's blessings, we can and will do mighty things in Jesus Christ. Amen? Amen. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we just thank you for this opportunity to be shown that you indeed are richly and abundantly blessing us so that we may bless others. That's why every time I end the messages on this podcast, every time I do, it's because I end it with, you're richly blessed, so be a blessing to others, so that you may be a blessing to others. And the reason why I say that, Lord, is because that is true. You have richly and abundantly blessed us. And you have also called us to be a blessing to others. So help us be that. And when we fail, remind us that we need to pick back up and try again. You are always with us. And with you, we will be not only blessed people, because we are, but we will be people who bless others. In your name. Amen. Friends, thank you for tuning in. I always enjoy having you listen to these messages, and I certainly hope that you're getting something out of them, and I would assume so if you keep coming back for more. With that said, I do want to let you know that we do have episode links in the episode notes, and of course, two of those links go to our giving pages, my church's giving pages. Again, these messages are for free. I would never charge for them. But if this is your main sustenance for the week, and you have it in you to be generous and bless our church through your blessings, that would be great, and we would be happy and blessed by that if you did. Of course, if this is not, you know, if this is supplementary and you have a church of your own, then please, by all means, support that church. They need it, and we all know that. So, by all means, if you can't give to us, give to your church community. But if you can give to both of us, then that would be even better. That would be best for both worlds. So, with that said, remember, friends, you are richly blessed, so that you may be a blessing to others. Go in peace.